In today's episode of Wicked Good Homes, we'll visit the estate of a prominent Revolutionary War hero. Now, he almost became known as the father of our country, but instead may be remembered as the father of the duplex-style house. Join me and Home Inspector Bill Fitzgerald for Wicked Good Homes. Welcome to Wicked Good Homes. I'm Peter Bohush. We're at the Artemas Ward Museum in Shrewsbury, Massachusetts. This was one of the finest houses in town in its day. The main house was built in 1727. That's the same year Shrewsbury was incorporated as a town, and the same year that a young baby named Artemas Ward was born. Now, Artemas went on to go to law school, get a degree at Harvard College, and later received an officer's commission in the King's Army. But these were restless times in the colonies, and Artemas played a dangerous game by denouncing the recently introduced Stamp Act. As the rebellion moved from acts of defiance to all-out war, Artemas was appointed commander-in-chief of the Revolutionary War forces in New England and found himself staring down the British Army in the Siege of Boston and the Battle of Bunker Hill. On the night of June 16, 1775, General Artemas Ward ordered his army to occupy the strategic heights of Bunker Hill. 2,200 British soldiers attacked the rebels, marching to within 50 feet of them before being decimated by musket volleys. But the Americans were low on ammunition, and the third attack overwhelmed their positions. The British won the battle, but paid a terrible price. 226 British soldiers died, and 828 were wounded. The Americans lost 140 killed and 271 wounded. Had he continued to lead the revolutionary forces, Artemas Ward may have become known as the father of our country. But he was ultimately replaced by a tall, stoic figure who rode into town on a white horse, none other than George Washington. And the rest is history. Or is it? Artemas Ward served in the Continental Army under George Washington as commander of the forces in New England. After the war, he was elected to Congress and served as a judge in many of the state's high courts. But his house remains today. It's a museum operated by Harvard University. We're going to tour the grounds on the outside and inside the house to see how people lived in colonial times. So join me as we visit the Artemas Ward House in Shrewsbury, Massachusetts. The main house was constructed in 1727, consisted of 5 rooms and 2 bedrooms. This is the parlor, or the formal living room. Entertaining would have been done here. As guests arrived, they would have been served tea and snacks here and chatted about the events of the day. Over the mantel, a portrait of the man himself, General Artemas Ward. Now take a look at the fireplace in the parlor. Beautiful detail in the molding throughout. And something really interesting in this fireplace. It looks like a fireplace. In fact, this is a wood board that covers the fireplace. Not only is this used for decorative purposes, but in the winter or cool days before they wanted to light a fire, this would have been used as essentially a damper to keep the cold air from coming in. And in the summer and spring, when they didn't light a fire, this would have been used to block the fireplace and the chimney to keep birds from flying down into the house. Around 1780, Artemas Ward and his wife Sarah discovered that tending the family estate was too much work for them in their old age. So they invited one of their sons and his family to join them. But now they had nearly a dozen people living in a 5-room house. So they did what a lot of parents did. They added on. Here we are in the foyer of the 1785 addition to the Artemas Ward House. In effect, what they did was create a duplex house in 1785. 2 front doors, 2 stairwells, 2 kitchens, several bedrooms, 2 separate residences connected by a common wall. This home is filled with all kinds of artifacts from the era that belonged to the general and his family. For example, here is a silver epaulette that would have been worn on the shoulder of a French army officer. It was taken from him after his demise, no doubt, during the French and Indian War. Near the front door of the house, gentlemen would have kept their hats. In this case, this is a beaver fur hat. Quite sporty. I believe these are coming back in style. You watch. And of course, also hanging by every front door would have been your fire brigade bucket. And this was General Artemas Ward's fire brigade bucket. Now, they didn't have fire departments or fire hydrants in the 1700s. So if you or a neighbor's house or barn caught on fire, someone would sound the alarm and yell to all the neighbors. They'd grab their buckets hanging by the front door, and off they went to save their neighbor's property.